if you ask me, it's because there's this girl.
Look! There's a wall their parents built between their houses.
They built it ages ago, last month, when I came home from school. Poor fools. They built it to keep us apart. Maybe she's there now. I hope so. I'll see. I don't know what to call her. She's too vibrant for a name. Juliet.
Yes, dear.
Eleanor.
Yes, dear.
Cassandra. Cleopatra. Beatrice. Guinevere.
Oh, dear.
I think she's there. Can you hear me?
Barely.
I've been speaking of it. I told them that if anyone were to ask me to describe you, I would be utterly and totally speechless. Except to say, perhaps you are Polaris. Or the inside of a leaf.
Speak a little louder.
I love you. If I were in the desert deep in sand, and the sun was burning like a hot on granite, walking through a nightmare in the heat of a summer's day, until my mind was parched. Then you are water, cool, clear water, a refreshing glass of water.
What, dear?
Fire alive with heat, a flame that thaws the iceberg with its heat.
Repeat.
You are heat.
Love.
you're trembling.
Well, my mother was a spy.
I know, I know. I had to climb out through a window. My father locked my room.
Gosh, be careful. Suppose you were to fall.
It's on the ground floor. Still, the window's very small. I could get stuck.
This is madness, isn't it?
Yes, it's absolutely mad.
And also very wicked.
Yes.
I'm glad.
My father would be furious if he knew.
Listen, I have had a vision.
Of disaster?
No, of azaleas. I dreamed I was picking an azalea. But all at once this duke, oh, he was very old, say he was nearly 40, and attractive, but very evil.
I hate him.
Then he had a retinue of scoundrels, and they were hiding behind the rhododendrons, and all at once, as I picked an azalea, he leaped out.
God, I hate him.
In my vision, how I struggled, like the ring of the Savannah women. I cried help!
And I was your right.
Yes. You come rushing to the rescue, and single-handed, you fight all his men and win.
And then?
Celebrations! Fireworks! We answer them! Laughter! Our parents give in!
We live happily ever after.
There's no reason in the world why it can't happen exactly like that.
Too much moisture. There are a great many things I could tell you about myself. I was once in the Navy. That's where I learned horticulture. Yes, I've been the world over. I've seen it all. The Japanese cactus, the century plant, and exotic ports where bogwort was sold on the open market. Yes, I'm a man of experience. And there's one thing that I've learned, is that too much moisture is worse than none at all. Prune plant. Avoid water. Go easy on manure. Moderation, that's the moral. That's my son's foot.
Hello, Father.
What are you doing up in the tree?
Reading verses?
Curses.
Cousin?
I offer a father's curses to the kind of education that makes our children fools. I sent this boy to school. I sent this boy to college. And I hope you know what that costs. Did he learn to dig a cesspool? No.
He's up there reading verses.
Why do I always find you standing beside the wall?
I'm waiting for it to fall. Besides, I like it. I like its lovely texture and pretty little eyes.
Wolves don't have eyes.
Then, what do you call this flower?
Sweet boy, he's clever.
Son, you're an ass. There you stand every day reading verses when who knows what our neighbour's up to on the other side of the wall. I'm not having. She's a villain. I'll strip down those branches where an enemy can climb. I'll line that wall with bottles. I'll jack it up with glass. What was that noise?
Some broken willow? Some little wounded bird?
Maybe, but wolves have ears, even if they don't have eyes. I'll just get up and take a look. Oh, there's that stiffness. The result of my Navy career. Son, you get up and take a look for me.
All right, Father.
Well, what do you see?
I love you.
What are you mumbling about? Get down if there's nothing to be seen. Get down, I say.
I obey.
So, you're an idiot, and I decided you to be married. So I went shopping this morning, and I picked you out a wife.
There's that sound again. Irish bird.
Weeping willow, maybe. Let's get back down to business. Son,
I picked you out a pearl. I picked you out a pearl.
And I prefer a diamond.
How dare you prefer a diamond when I picked you out a pearl?
Listen carefully to what I have to say. Listen, wall, and willow, and flowers, and wounded bird. And Father, you may as well listen too. I will not wed by your wisdom. I will not walk meekly into a church and contract out to prolongate my race. I will not go wedding in a too tight suit, nor be witness when I take my bride.
You will?
No! I'll marry when I marry, in my own particular way. And my bride shall dress in sunlight, with rain for her wedding day. Out in the open, with no one standing by. No song except September, being sung in the busy grass. No sound except our hearts roaring, like a flower alive with bees. Without benefit of neighbor, without benefit of book, except perhaps her handprint, when she presses her hand in mine. Except perhaps her imprint, when she gives me her golden hair, in a field, while kneeling, being joined by the joy of life.
Son, you need pruning. Come inside and write simplicity 200 times. Maybe that will improve your style.
Love's got to break.
Soldiers must fight.
swim, the water made him wince, until I said he mustn't swim. He's been swimming ever since.
Spectacular raid that crosses orbit from the
Tits. A major production requires a sense.
Life sounds expensive.
Just try to see it, and you will soon succeed. So yours, why? Just a trifle to you.
There. Imagine. Oh, it's torn, I know. Don't think about it. It vanishes under the light. That's the whole trick. Imagine me under light. And I recite. Try me. Give me a cure. Go on, I know. Try me.
Friends, Romans, countrymen.
It's a what now?
Friends, Romans, countrymen.
Oh, don't tell me. Okay. Friends, Romans, countrymen. Oh, well, of course. Well, that's easy. Why didn't you give me something hard? Friends, Romans, fellow countrymen, screw your courage to the sticking place. Be not sick and pale of face, that thou or handmaids are more handsome than she. There, how's that?
Marvelous.
Imagine the number of light. I assure you, it's dazzling. I am Henry Albert. Perhaps you remember my Hamlet?
Of course.
You do? Oh, good. I have the tribute.
Absolutely.
Well, whatever. I deserve it. Perhaps one day I shall write a book. This is Mortimer. He's an expert at doing deaths. He's been with me for 40 years. Would you like to see one? Mortimer, die for the gentleman.
Something like the abduction of this maiden before his lover.
And what if he should blench?
We shall stand our ground and fight until a lot of us is down.
Why, nobody done.
Where are we, Henry?
What? Oh, stage left. The Indians are always stage left, Morgan.
What's with you?
Oh, I'll tell you when we come to it.
Right.
And clean up the stage. Don't cluster the stage when you die, Morris. Don't cluster the stage. He's not really an Indian. Well, I suppose we should play.
Oh, I nearly forgot. I promised them moonlight.
Amazing.
Beautiful, eh? A lover's moon. Go ahead, Henry. I'll be right there. You wonder how these things begin. Well, this begins with a clam. It begins with a season which, for want of a better word, we might as well call September. It begins with a forest where woodchucks woo and leaves back spring and vines and vine like numbers. Try to see it, not with your eyes for they are wise, but see it with your ears. The cool green breathing of the leaves. And hear it with the inside of your hand, the sound of shadows flicking light. Celebrate sensation. Recall that secret place. You've been there, you remember, a special place where once, just once in your Protestant lifetime, you hid away in shadows from the tyranny of time. That spot beside the clover where someone's hand held your hand, and love was sweeter than the berries, or the honey, or the stinging taste of mint. It is September, before a rainfall, a perfect time to be in love.
Thank you.
of a tree.
Thank you. sore. Dwayne worked at it. It ain't the easiest thing in the business. But I like it. I've been Dwayne for 40 years now, since I was a boy. You should see me in those days. I could Dwayne backwards off a 20-foot cliff. People used to cry out, "Die again, Mortimer! Die again!" But of course I never did.
Are you off now?
Yes, somewhere. There's not much left of the old company now, just Mortimer and myself. But we get by. I always like Shakespeare, Mortimer dies, and somewhere there's an audience.
Oh, here's the room. Thank you. Good night, sweet prince.
A stream of angels sing. That's my life. Angels sing me through my life. Why doth the drum come? Remember, Mortimer, there are no small actors, no small parts.
Remember me in life!
A group of living statues, what do they call them? A tango. I wonder if they can hold it. They'll try to, I suppose. Yet it won't be easy to hold such a pretty pose. We will see. We will leave them for a bit, and then we will see. Act one is over. It's the intermission now.
It looks different in the daylight.
some of the garments, so. Though.
Neighbor!
Friend!
In-law! This is what we've always wanted. Our garden's a one.
We're married.
Related.
Related. Well.
What shall we do today?
Whatever you say.
Tomorrow?
The same. I wonder where that road goes.
I'm going to take my hair down and go swimming in the stream.
Water, water, water.
What?
I said, water, water, water.
Clip, clip, clip.
What is it?
You're clipping my kumquat. Fantastic.
You see, they are just
sweet. Just like drama, parents always play the fool.
I could speak if I wanted to.
Speak what? Shh,
better
not. No, I'll be silent. But you better not push it too much further.
You forget that I'm a hero. After all, there's my relic.
And my rape.
What sort of thing. And I was really living.
And handsome man is. His hands, he grabbed me here. Just a little ribbon on the spot.
Those hot-blooded bandits. And I cut them down like wheat.
I can speak if I wanted to.
It's tempting, but we should. It should be made into an epic poem.
All right.
Oh, Betty, a shrine.
Did I? I'll build it.
Oh, where the wall was.
On this very spot, I heard your call. And here beside our parents' wall, I drew my sword and slew them all. How many? 20?
30.
Yes, or even 32. And everyone who wants to slay, I slew.
Ass.
I beg your pardon?
I said, son, you're an ass.
Charming.
Isn't it? He behaves just like a pantaloon.
That's done it!
Wait!
No, I'm no pantaloon. Do you think that walls come tumbling down? Do you think that brigands find an open gate, the way prepared? Do you think that's fate?
What do you mean?
Do you think that parents play the fool to children barely out of school?
Well, they do in books.
In books, maybe. But it's not the same in reality. No, children play on puppet stages, prepared by parents' hard-won wages. Or do you think such things come free? Do you think a first-class rape comes free? Good heavens. It's the villain's fee.
What's this?
An 8-mile bill for your pretty little rape. You.
We arranged it.
On the wall?
Built to fall.
I don't believe it.
Read on, Macduff.
Aye. A piece in silver for actor to portray Indian raiding party. Body paint included? Item. A piece in gold to the famous El Gallo to allow himself appear wounded by a bearded callow boy. Item. One moon. But I see you've spared no pains.
You mean it wasn't real? The bandits? The moonlight?
Everything.
Well, that isn't fair. We didn't need it, your bandits or moon. We're in love. We could have made it our own moonlight as a child.
We were just puppets.
Marriage of convenience. Look what you've done.
I told you it wouldn't work.
You told you? You liar! And get out of my kumquat!
Damn your kumquat!
Wait!
It's my bandit!
You are El Gallo.
Sometimes.
About this bill. I think you've earned it rather easily.
You made it easy to earn.
Yeah, well, this time I'm going to make it hard.
Good boy.
Where's my sword? Somebody get me a sword!
En garde!
En perpétuel, that twist.
That foot! Back more!
We hit the entrails.
That's it!
Fucking! Stun! Still! Free!
Bethany!
And again! Don't forget to curl! Practice! See? Another lesson?
So sarcastic.
I shall be sarcastic whenever I choose to.
What, you think I couldn't do it?
I think you better grow up. Grow up. Grow up.
And this from a girl who's 16.
Girls want to be faster.
Oh, this can't be happening. If I'm not mad, if I'm not gloriously insane, then I'm just me again. And if I'm me, then I can see.
What?
Everything! All the flaws! You're childish.
Childlike.
Silly.
So cool.
And you've got freckles.
That's a lie!
I can see them under the pounds of powder. Look! Freckles.
I hate you!
Self-deception. And it's a sign of immaturity to wear lavender perfume before you're 40.
You're a poser. I heard you stomping around in the garden, reciting romantic poems about yourself. The bold hero.
Now you're out of lessons.
But what?
I said you're out of lessons. Beyond that road lies adventure.
I'm going to take my hair down and I'll go swimming in a stream.
You'll never hear me again, my dear. I decided to be back.
I'm going to sit up all night and I'll sing songs to the moon.
Yeah, well, I'm going to drink and gamble and go handlebars. I'm going to find my madness out there somewhere.
I'll find mine too. I'll have a fair.
Goodbye forever.
This tear is enough. This tiny tear to save the entire world. A boy may go, a girl must stay. Thus runs the world away. See, he sees it, and the world seems very grand.
Beyond that road lies a shining world.
Beyond that road lies despair.
Beyond that road lies a world that's gleaming.
People who are scheming.
Beauty,
hunger,
glory,
sorrow.
Never a pain.
Sure.
Sorry, I forgot. You're not supposed to talk.
Louisa! Now listen, dear. It's silly to stand in the garden. You'll catch pneumonia. You'll catch asthma. Louisa? Oh, well. I brought you a little shawl. I don't suppose you'd care to see my garden.
He won't answer.
Don't recall addressing that remark to you, sir.
He's not supposed to speak.
Oh, well. By the way...
Yes?
Nothing. What's so funny?
I was just remembering how we used to meet.
Climbing over the wall.
Secret meetings.
Just to have a little game of cards. How's your son?
Not a word.
He'll be back. When he's run out of your money.
Thanks. And your daughter?
Like a statue. Does nothing but dream of him.
Pity. How's your garden?
Growing.
Mine too.
So dependable. Gardens go on growing.
Yes, indeed they do.
I tell you, I love the chickens.
It's true. I love them too.
Plant a radish, get a radish, never any doubt. That's well a vegetables, you know what you're about.
Plant a turnip, get a turnip, maybe you'll get two. That's why I love vegetables, you know that they are.
They're dependable,
very friendable. They're the best
kind of parents ever known. Well, with children,
it's bewildering.
You don't know until the seed is nearly grown. Just watch it, so plant a carrot. That's where the vegetables, you know what you're about. Life is very,
if it's very vegetarian.
A man with lots of garden is a very happy man.
Plant a beanstalk, get a beanstalk, just the same as jam. Then if you don't like it, you can always take it back.
If your ship does the kiss you, then I wish you luck. You plant a chatter and you're absolutely stuck. Every turn of the wheel, every kid's a need. Every bankroll also coming to the pot.
Now the tragedy
is unfun to me.
Thank you.
bandits.
You're bandits?
Yes.
I'm
Forget it. The evening just started. Round and round and round and round and round and the slow fields play. Any part of the field that way, breakfast and therapy.
Remember too that one particular kiss.
will return. That necklace.
It's my mother's.
Good. It will serve as your pledge.
All right. I give you this necklace. Because it's my favorite thing. Garbage. I won't be long. Is it really like you say? Is the world like you say?
Of course.
When the moon was young, when
diamond was made when the stage was hung for my holiday. I saw shining lights, but I never knew they were you. They were you. They were you.
It's beginning to snow.